Hello Ace, this is RetroTK2 and welcome to this Unity tutorial. Today I'll race through the bare basics of Unity with you. This is a very brief tutorial Ace, as I don't want to spend too long on Unity at this point. So let's get started. Open Unity and create a project Ace. If this is the first time you've opened Unity, it'll probably have the default window layout. To change this window layout, click on the layout dropdown in the top right corner and choose whichever one you like Ace. I use a modified 2x3, but try each layout to see which one suits you better. Right clicking on the project tab will give you an option to change from a 2 column layout to a 1 column layout. If you want to open a window, click window in the top menu bar and click the one you want. Here I click console and the window opens. Most of the windows in Unity are dockable. When they are not docked, you can drag them like a standard window. If you click and hold the windows tab and drag it, the window will snap into place beside or below another dockable window. I usually place the console below the hierarchy window Ace. Resizing the console window will cause the hierarchy window to shrink. If I grab the game object window, I can place it beside the scene tab. This allows me to swap between the two Ace. If I resize the game window, you'll see the hierarchy and console windows shrink and grow with it. If I grab the project tab, I can place it beside the hierarchy window and the console window stretches below both. Customize your layout Ace, and when you're happy with it, click on the layout dropdown. Click save layout, name it and click save. Now you can change the layout and revert back to your saved one at any time Ace. Let's have a brief look at what each window does. I'll discuss them in depth in later videos Ace. The scene window shows all the game objects in your scene. Currently you can see the directional light and main camera. If you right click and hold inside this window and move the mouse around, you can rotate the scene camera. You can also press WASD to move forward, backward and side to side respectfully. Combine this with the mouse move and you can navigate through the scene pretty nicely Ace. The game window shows the actual view of the game. This is usually the view from the main camera, but it can also be the view from GUI cameras or cameras placed in layers on top of each other. The hierarchy window shows a list of all the game objects in your scene. Clicking on one of these will select it and changes the inspector window. This window shows all the components that are attached to the selected game object. All game objects in the scene have a transform component that controls the position and rotation of an object in the scene. The transform component can be manipulated in the scene by clicking on one of the arrows on the gizmo and dragging the mouse in the arrow's direction. So for example, if I click the up arrow on the gizmo, hold and move the mouse up or down, it'll change the game object's position, as you can see in the inspector. You can change the gizmo used to affect the transform by clicking the buttons at the top or using the keyboard shortcuts. Pressing Q will select the pan tool, pressing W selects the position gizmo, pressing E selects the rotation gizmo, pressing R selects the scaling gizmo, and pressing T will select the canvas resize gizmo. These are out of the scope of this video Ace, and we'll discuss them in future videos. For now, select the rotation gizmo and move the mouse over the green circle. Left click, hold and move the mouse left or right. This will rotate the transform, and as you can see in the inspector, the Y rotational value changes as we do this. Let's add a cube to our scene. Click game object, 3D object, cube in the top menu bar. If I select the cube, we can see that this game object has a transform component like all other game objects. Different components on the cube game object makes it a cube. The mesh renderer and mesh filter components are what allow it to be rendered as a cube, and the box collider components allows it to get affected by physics. Game objects are a collection of components Ace. The main camera object has a camera component and a couple of other components that make it the camera object. If I select the cube object and update its transform position, we can see that it is updated in the scene window and the game window. This is what the camera component can see Ace. If I position the cube at 000, click the main camera object and move it closer to the cube, you can see it update in the game window. To remove a game object, select it and press delete. Let's add an empty game object. Click game object, create empty from the top menu. If I select this game object, you'll see it only has a transform component attached to it. Now we'll make our own component Ace. Right click on the project window and click create C# script. Call the script whatever you like Ace, just make sure it doesn't have any spaces or special characters in it. This creates a C# script. Let's talk about scenes Ace. A scene is a file that contains all the game objects in the hierarchy. If I press Ctrl S, a dialog window will pop up asking me to save my scene file. A scene file has to be saved somewhere inside the assets folder, as this is the directory the project window uses. If I name the scene and save it, you'll see that the scene is now available in the project window. If I create a new scene by clicking on File, New Scene, the hierarchy window updates. Pressing Ctrl S will save a new scene file. If I double click on the previous saved scene, the scene will be loaded in and the hierarchy will change. Double clicking on the other scene will load it in and you can swap between them Ace. Right clicking on the scene and clicking delete will remove it. If I right-click on the project window and click Show in Explorer, it'll bring us to the Unity Projects Assets folder. A Unity project has its own directory structure. The Assets folder is where all the game resources are stored, including scripts, textures, sounds, materials, scenes, pretty much anything that goes into the game. The project window displays everything that is in this folder. The library folder holds a local cache of imported project assets. The OBJ and Temp folder are used for temporary files, and the project settings stores build settings and other settings for the project. Okay, let's go back to the C# script we created earlier. If we double click on the script, it should open in a program called MonoDevelop. The script we created creates a class of the same name. This class inherits from another class called MonoBehavior. Having the class inherit from MonoBehavior means that you can attach the script to a game object as a component. This probably doesn't make too much sense at the minute, but it'll become clearer once we look at C# and other videos. If we go back into Unity, click and drag the script onto a game object, you'll see a new component is added to the game object with the same name as our script. Using this script, we can add behavior to our game, yes. This is a very brief tutorial, but hopefully it's covered just enough to get us started with Unity. And that's it. Rate, comment, and subscribe, yes. I hope you're enjoying the series so far. You can email me at retrotk2@gmail.com with any questions you have. I know I've already used Alan Walker's Fade song in one of my previous videos, yes, but I just had to use it again after I heard it on the radio. I'm so happy for Alan and NCS, it'll be cool to hear more of their songs hitting the charts. Thank you for watching this, and I'll see you in the next video.